Good afternoon, children. Welcome to 6th standard online class. Hope you are all safe by the grace of God. Today we are going to continue our 4th unit, the living world of plants. Yesterday we were discussing about the habitat, types of habitat, isn't it? The major two types of habitats are aquatic habitat and terrestrial habitat. Aquatic habitat is nothing but areas permanently covered by water. Am I right, children? Yes. In that, we have learnt about the freshwater habitat. Today, we are going to continue the same chapter. So, this aquatic habitat is classified into freshwater habitat and marine water habitat, isn't it? Aquatic habitat is classified into freshwater habitat and marine water habitat. Yesterday we have discussed this freshwater habitat. Freshwater means rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. So today we are going to discuss about this marine water habitat. Let us see what is marine water habitat. Marine water habitat: from outer space, earth looks like an awesome blue marble. That's because most of earth's surface, more than 70%, is covered by oceans. Oceans also support the growth of plants. Marine plants perform about 40% of all photosynthesis that occurs on the planet. So we know that earth is covered by, 3/4 of the earth is covered by water, right? Yes. So this water, 70% of the earth's surface is covered by oceans. Am I right, children? Yes. That's why these oceans also support the growth of plants. We know that plants grow even under the ocean. Those oceanic plants are called as marine plants. Marine plants. Okay. So, this marine plants perform about 40% of all photosynthesis occurs on the planet. So, in our earth, the photosynthesis, you know what is photosynthesis? The preparation of the food by the leaves of the plant is called photosynthesis, isn't it? So, in that photosynthesis, nearly 40% of the photosynthesis is done by this marine plants. Do you understood, children? Yes. Examples for marine plants are marine algae, sea grasses, marsh grasses, phytoplanktons are the examples of this marine plants. Okay, what are they? Marine algae, sea grasses, marsh grasses, phytoplanktons are examples for this marine plants. Okay, children, do you understand? Yes. So we know that meaning for marine algae, isn't it? Algae, you know. In Tamil, we used to say pasi, isn't it? Yes. Then sea grasses, the grass that grows under the sea grasses. But what about this marsh grass? Marsh grass is nothing but, marsh is the area which is wet land. In English, we call it as wet land. In common language, we call it as wet land. In Tamil, we used to say sadupunila idangal. Okay. So, sadupunilam. Sadupunilam means this marsh. Okay. So, the grasses grown in those marsh areas are called as marsh grasses. You understood? So, shall we see a picture of marsh grass? Yes. So, this is the picture of marsh grass. Do you understand? So, this is a marsh grass and it grows in wetlands, that is marshy areas. Do you understood, children? Yes, good. The next one is phytoplanktons. Phytoplanktons, they are nothing but algaes. They are nothing but microalgaes which are present in this oceanic water. Microalgaes which are present in the oceanic waters. So these are all marine algae, sea grasses, marsh grass, phytoplanktons are the examples for this. Which one? This marine habitat. Is it clear, children? Yes. So the next type of habitat is terrestrial habitat. Terrestrial habitat. Among the two major types, we have already discussed the aquatic habitat. Now we are going to discuss the terrestrial habitat. Terrestrial habitats are the one that are found on land. Found on land like forests, grasslands, and a desert. It also includes man-made habitats like farms, towns, cities. They can be as big as continent or as small as an island. They can make up about 28% of the entire world habitat. Is it clear, children? Yes. So this terrestrial habitat is classified into three types. They are desert, grasslands, forest. First, let us discuss about the desert habitat. A habitat without much water is called desert. Deserts are the driest place on earth. They get fewer than 25 centimeters of rainfall annually. Deserts cover at least 20% of the earth. The plants which grows in this habitat have thick leaves that store water and minerals. The plants like cactus store water in their stem and the leaves are reduced to spines. They have long roots that go very deep in the soil in search of water. So this we know that about desert, isn't it? Deserts are the driest place on the earth. So they get very less amount of rainfall, fewer than 25 centimeter of annual rainfall. So this desert covers at least 20% of the earth's surface. Then the planet that which grows in this habitat, the plants that grows in this habitat have thick leaves. They have thick leaves. The leaves will be normally thick. Why? Because in order to store the water and minerals. The plants like cactus store water in their stem. And the leaves are reduced to spines. Spines means sharp thorns. Sharp tiny thorns. Is it clear, children? They have long roots. That go very deep in the soil. In search of water. Okay. We know that the roots alone absorb the water. Isn't it? So this roots, since in desert areas very less amount of water will be present, the roots have to go deep inside the soil in search of water. For that, these desert plants have very long roots. Is it clear, children? Hope you have understood. Am I right? Yes. So this is the diagrammatic representation of desert plants. Do you get it, children? So some of the types of deserts are hot dry deserts, semi-arid desert, coastal deserts, cold deserts. Okay. So what are the types of deserts? Hot dry deserts, semi-arid desert, coastal deserts, and cold deserts. So hot desert, as the name prevails, it will be very very extremely hot. Semi arid, the circulation of air will be there. Coastal, which are the deserts which are present in the coastal regions. Coastal means near the beaches. Okay, then cold deserts, there will be very the temperature will be very cold there. Even though they are desert, the temperature will be cold there. Then example for this for the desert habitat plants are cactus, agave, aloe, bryophyllum. Cactus, agave, aloe, bryophyllum are the examples for desert habitat plants. Is it clear, children? Yes. So in our country we have Thar desert, isn't it? You know that, isn't it? So this Thar desert is also called as Great Indian Desert. Great Indian Desert. So this is an arid region of rolling sand hills on Indian subcontinent. It is located partly in Rajasthan state. Rajasthan state is located in the northwest of India. Partly located in Rajasthan state and partly in Punjab and Sindh provinces and East Pakistan. Not only in Rajasthan, even in Punjab and Sindh provinces, that is present in the East Pakistan. Okay, so this is about the interesting fact about the desert which is present in our own country. Okay, now the next topic is grassland habitat. Grassland habitat. So let us discuss what is a grassland habitat. Grassland is an area where vegetation is dominated by the grasses. Vegetation is dominated by the grasses. Grasses ranges from short to tall. Example, savanna grassland. Savanna grassland is the best example for this grassland habitat. Okay, see, in Tamil we used to say no pulveli. That is the grassland habitat. Is it clear, children? So look here, this is a diagrammatic representation of a grassland habitat. Okay, children. Okay, now forest habitat. Forest habitat, a forest is a large area dominated by trees. There are three types of forest and they are tropical forest, temperate forest and mountain forest. Tropical forest, temperate forest and mountain forest. Annual rainfall ranges from 25 to 200 centimeter. So there are three types of in forest. The large area is dominated by the trees. The three types of forest habitat are tropical forest, temperate forest and mountain forest. The annual rainfall ranges from 25 to 200 centimeter. Is it clear, children? Yes. So here is the diagrammatic representation of forest habitat. This forest habitat brings the it's a place of many rare species of plants and animals. Is it clear, children? Yes. So today's class, I'm sure today's class is a quite interesting one. Am I right, children? Yes. We have discussed about the other type of aquatic habitat, that is marine water habitat, and the terrestrial habitats and their types. Am I right, children? I hope you have understood thoroughly. Complete the assignment. Keep preparing for the forthcoming exams. Thank you, children. Stay home, stay safe, obey your parents, make your parents to get vaccinated. Subscribe to our school channel, children. Thank you.